Hello students, today we'll start chapter 5, lines and angles. So there's something we have to know before we get on with the exercise. That is number one, line. What is line? So line in geometry is defined as a figure which can be drawn endlessly to both the side and which has no thickness. Okay, line segment. Line segment is a part of line only, but line segment has two distinct points, that is two endpoints. Remember this. Number three, angle. Angle is formed when lines or line segment meet. So this is, these are the line, two lines. When these two lines are meeting here, they are forming angles. How? See, this is one angle, two arms. This is one angle, this is another angle. Fine. This is another angle, number three. And this is another angle, that is four. So four angles are forming when two lines are intersecting at one point. Also, when the line segments meet at one point, they form an angle. That is, this line segment and this line segments are meeting here. So they are forming one angle here. This line segment and this line segment are meeting here. So they are forming one angle here. This line segment and this line segment is meeting in this point. So they will also form an angle. So, angle is formed when lines or line segments meet. Okay, that means angle has two arms. Angle has two arms. Okay. Number four, complementary angle. When the sum of the measures of the two angles is 90 degrees. Suppose two angles are given and if you see their sum is 90 degrees, then they are called complementary angles. Okay. This is also complementary angle, you can say. That is, suppose... this is 45 degree. This is another angle given, 45 degree. So 45 plus 45 is what? 90. So these two angles are called complementary angles. Okay. When the sum of two angle measures 90 degree, they are called complementary angles. Number five, supplementary angle. When the sum of the measures of the two angle is 180 degree. Complementary angle was what? 90 degree. And supplementary angle is what? 180 degree. When the two angles measures 180 degree. See, one is 60 degree, another is 120 degree. So if you add these two, you will get 180 degree. So these angles are called supplementary angles. Okay. Now let's move on to number six. Adjacent angle. Now you have to understand this. What is adjacent angle? Now adjacent angles are what? Angles such that they have a common vertex. See, this angle, this is one angle and this is another angle. So these two angles are having common vertex. This is common vertex. Okay, this angle, see again, this is angle number one and this is angle number two. So these two angles are sharing one point. This is. So the adjacent angles always have a common vertex. They have a common arm. See, this arm is shared with this angle one also and this arm is shared with angle two also. They have a common arm also and common vertex also. Similarly, this is also our adjacent angle. See, this is a common vertex that these two angles are sharing and this is a common arm that these two angles are sharing with each other. So these are the adjacent angles. Now what is a linear pair? The angles in a linear pair are supplementary. That is, the sum of the angles always has to be 180 degree. So you see, we know that we have studied in the junior classes that this is what? A straight line. Straight line always comprises what? 180 degree. Fine. So always linear angles would be over the straight line. Fine. So this is what I am trying to understand. That is, see, if this is a straight line and this straight line has been divided into two angles. So the sum of these two angles will be equals to 180 degree. Fine. So angle 1 plus angle 2 is 180 degree. Though they are adjacent also, as because they are sharing the common vertex and arm, but when the sum of these two angles, when the sum of the angles are 180 degree, then they are also called linear pair. This is not a linear pair, you see. This is not in the straight line. This is something like this. So we cannot say that angle 1 plus angle 2 is 180 degree. Okay. So when this, when the angles sum is 180 degree, then we will call it as linear pair. See, the angles in a linear pair are supplementary. It has to be 180 degree. So it has to be always on the over the straight line, not anything like this. Okay. Now vertically opposite angle, when the two lines are intersecting at one particular point. So the opposite angle, you see, these two angles are called vertically opposite angles. So I've seen angle 1 is equals to angle 2, angle 1 is equals to angle 2, and angle 4 is equals to angle 3. Okay, so this is also called vertically opposite angle. These are also called vertically opposite angle. These are opposite angles. Fine, so this relation is called vertically opposite angles. Okay, so this was all the notes regarding this chapter. Now you have to, your assignment for today is exercise 5.1, sum number 1, 2 and 3 all. In question number 1, you will find that you have to pair up which are the complementary angles. In question number 2, you have to again pair up which are the supplementary angles. And in question number 3 also, might be they have given the 2 degrees in each question. So you just have to add it and you have to say whether it is a complementary angle or that is a supplementary angle. Very, very easy. Okay, so see this video. If in case you have any problem, share it in the WhatsApp group. If not, then start with the assignment, that is exercise 5.1, sum number 1, 2, 3, all sum you have to do. 1 all, 2 all, 3 all. Okay, thank you and God bless you all.